So when they first told me I had 25 minutes to talk, I said, I am not talking for 25 minutes. So I'm going to get you out of here in about 3. About 3 minutes. You know, Juan, I'm super excited. And for the last, few months, I can't stop or contain my excitement about this organization, about what we do. And I remember when I first took a look at the opportunity, and I got a phone call. And after hanging up from that phone call, I said, wow, they called me. Because when I think about my journey, although I'm new to Community Action Partnership, the issue of poverty and working with families and individuals who are disenfranchised is not new to me. And so the more I looked at my journey, the more I looked at what was next for me in my own career and the things that I want to do, how I want to make a difference. Because it's not about a career, it's not about, you know, another thing on my resume. It's really about how do I position myself to be in a position to serve those who need help. And this organization opened the door for me to be able to do that in a way that I have not done before. And I'm pretty excited about that. Now, there are board members here who had me up pretty late last night. They didn't realize I was still on East Coast time. So it was like midnight in my body by the time I got home. But I want to appreciate you. And for all the board members here, if you can raise your hand or stand and let us appreciate you. Because although I'm in my 9th week working with this board and seeing the commitment and compassion, those who've been around for a long time, those who are new to the board, new to the organization, I'm really looking forward to a long journey of working with this board. Prior to coming to Community Action Partnership, I ran an organization that worked with veterans, and we were primarily working with veterans who are homeless. And although I'm not a veteran, I learned a few things about being a veteran. I feel like I am one now. So one of the things they talk about as a veteran, they always say, I got my six. I got my six. I got my six. And what that means is, I got my buddies. I got my battle buddies. That we're gonna leave no veteran behind. And you know, we're gonna take care of one another. And so I'm proud that I got my six too. So wherever I go, it's nice to kind of look into the crowd. And I have a senior leadership team that they let me know that I'm not by myself. And that whenever you come into an organization and you're always concerned, are they gonna like me? Am I gonna like them? You kind of play that battle, but they've been tremendous in helping me get acclimated. So I want them to stand and be recognized on my senior leadership team for those points. And then I want to thank all of you, because this is what this event is all about. Thanking those who have partnered with us and on this journey of over 50 years of fighting this war against poverty. And so when I had a great opportunity to meet Dan today, and meet Abby today, and Todd came and visited me, I guess 2 weeks ago now, and we sat in my office, and I have a different appreciation for Fluid Master now, thanks to Todd. And so when I think about all the different individuals who I've had the chance to meet over the last 9 weeks or so, and there's so many more on the list that we haven't gotten to yet, I have a lot of appreciation for the work that we do and the lives that we're changing, because poverty is a global issue. And as I was driving here, I was thinking, there's so many things that can divide us. As a country, as individuals, as in neighborhoods and communities, there's a lot of things that can divide us. But I think there's a cause that we are involved in that really brings different people together. And I think Dan at our table said it great when he talked about the relationship between PEMCO and Community Action Partnership. It is a great model and a great example of how public and private partnerships can work and really make a difference and change people's lives. And they gave me a list of stuff to kind of talk about, and I can go down the numbers, and some of those things you've heard already. So you heard Mark talk about 24,000 boxes of food that we give out to seniors every single month. That's amazing. Over 20 million, almost 21 million pounds of food that we are giving out every single year to those families who are in need. That is amazing. I was in DC a few weeks ago, and I was bragging about 21 million pounds of food that we give out. Until someone said, we give out 60 million. And on one level, there was a little competition. I felt like, you know, we're doing nothing compared to what they're doing. But it was a reminder that globally, there's a lot of people who are in need of food. And the fact that in Denver, they're doing 60 million, in Orange County, we're doing 21 million, and who knows what they're doing in LA, who knows what they're doing in Chicago, and in New York City, and all across this country. When you think about the millions of food that's been given out by food banks and food pantries every single year, that lets you know that we have a problem. And what was exciting and was and at the same time, I'm taken back by it. The fact that we've been around for 50 years, the fact that we're giving out so many pounds of food, the thousands of families that we are helping keep the lights on. As I was sitting here and I was listening to Sally talk, and Sally was talking about, you know, the fact that we help keep people's lights on. I thought about my own life when I was 7 years old. I'm from New Jersey. And I was born and raised in the housing projects in New Jersey. And I remember being 7 or 8 years old, and it's Christmas time, and our lights were out. And I remember going back to school. After, you know, your Christmas break, you go back to school, everybody's, you know, they got new sneakers or new coats or new bikes, and everybody's bragging about the stuff that they got over Christmas. And our teachers having us all talk about what happened over the Christmas break. And I had to tell them that I had Christmas in the dark. And I didn't think about it until Sally started talking. And it wasn't just me. And that journey journey is not over, because there's people today, as Maribel and others talked about what we're doing in our family resource centers, there's other individuals who are going through that same challenge. Imagine having Christmas in the dark. Imagine being hungry and trying to study for school. Imagine, you know, 1 in 5 children in Orange County go to bed hungry every single night. 350,000 families are living in poverty right here in Orange County. So when I think about that journey and think about the fact that poverty is more than just food, it's more than energy, it's more than education. And I think what, you know, one of the things I talked last night with the board about, as I talked about, you know, my journey of being here for so long, is that there's so much more we can do. If we only focus on food, and that's all we did, and this whole event was about hunger, and we had posters all around this room, and all we did was talk about hunger and food, you would still walk away and think, man, we have a problem. If all we talked about energy and weatherization and all the families that we're helping around energy and energy efficiency and those families who are in need of services, if that's all we talked about for these 2 hours, you would still walk away and say, wow, that organization is going to work. If they came back up here and talked about the karate program, or other, the after-school program, the work with our seniors that we're doing, both in Anaheim and in Almedina, in Orange. If that's all we talked about, we give you a whole profile on the work that we're doing now, you will walk away and say, wow, that organization is doing a lot of work. But guess what? What makes Community Action Partnership so powerful is that we're doing it all. And guess what? There's more that we're going to do. There's more that we want to do. So when we think about the homeless issue and workforce development and education and STEM classes and all the other things that are out there that have an impact into poverty, it's not enough. That's the challenge. So my 100 days has been, wow, is asking myself the question, we were born out of the war on poverty, but are we winning the war on poverty? And when I was in D.C. last week, talking to our executive director of our National Community Action Foundation, and he and I spent some one-on-one time, and I asked him a question, because it's been lingering with me. Are we winning the war on poverty? Once I begin to learn that history, are we winning that war? And on some level, he gave me a great answer. He said, you know, we're not winning it, but we're not losing it. And he said, we got to find a way to be more innovative. We got to find a way to do more, to break the cycle of poverty. So we're not serving the same families year after year, and month after month, and the same seniors who are, you know, worried about where their next meal is going to come from. There's still so much more that we can be doing. And I think the power of Community Action Partnership here in Orange County, I'm working with other organizations, work with 1OC, just work with all of our partners, is finding a way to create a system that we're breaking the cycle of poverty for families. So if you're asking me, what was my 100 days look like, that's been my thought process. You gotta figure out, you know, messaging, and you know, we had a funny conversation about messaging while we're sitting at the table. And we're struggling with that, our own message. Because when people say, well, what does Community Action Partnership do? And I fumble with my words, because we do so much. We gotta figure that out. We gotta figure out how do we create more resources so that we are not just on hand to what government resources tell us to do. How do we become more innovative, and how do we become more nimble so that we can create the system of change? And I think that's where you come along and partner with us, alongside of us, and we leverage our relationship to help us be innovative, to help us be creative, so we can do something we've never done before, which is help families break the cycle of homelessness and poverty and lack of education and hope. I'm never gonna forget 1984 when she said, one day I'm gonna be in the Olympics. I'm never gonna forget that story because somebody stole her hope. And so one of the things that we do for kids, we do for families, we do for ourselves, is give people back their hope. And so if you wanna know what I've been thinking about, that's what I've been thinking about. So I couldn't go through all the numbers and all of that, but I think Mark and Sally did that already. You know what the numbers look like. You know us. You know what we're about. We are working on becoming an excellent organization, an organization of change. We don't want to just exist for existence sake, but we want to make a difference. And that's what I'm committed to. It's only been 9 weeks, but I feel like I've been here forever. So, it's just become a great fit. And I'm excited about where we're going, what we're going to do. So once again, I just want to thank you. Thank you for your partnership. Thank you for coming out today. When I hear that, you know, we've been in partnership with many of you for 20 years or 27 years, and they're going to do it again, and they're going to do it again and again. That says a lot about who we are, a lot about the staff that's here. And I'm excited about that. I'm excited about that partnership. And I'm looking forward to many more years to come where we are making a difference. So thanks again for coming today.